NASCAR has recognized the St. Louis area as a market where they want to be. And you know what? You all deserve it. Before I get off the stage, I'm going to say it one more time. It's cup time, St. Louis. At this time, I'd like to invite Ben Kennedy to the stage. Ben, welcome to town. From St. Louis to the France family and all of NASCAR, thank you very much.
Thank you, Curtis. That is that's a tough act to follow. But first and foremost, thank you very much, Curtis, for you and the entire Worldwide Technology Raceway team for having me here today. Congratulations to you. Today is obviously a huge day for our sport. One of the biggest days that we have in the entire year as we announce the 2022 NASCAR Cup Series schedule. Changes in the schedule, one of the biggest changes is we'll be introducing the Worldwide Technology Raceway to the June 5th weekend here in St. Louis, so we can't wait to see it happen. You know, we've seen racing here in St. Louis for the past 20 years with the NASCAR Camping World Truck Series. We've seen it with the Xfinity Series. A lot of great names have gone to Victory Lane here in St. Louis with the likes of Martin Truex Jr., Bubba Wallace, NASCAR Cup Series champion Kevin Harvick. A lot of great winners that are currently in our Cup Series have been to Victory Lane here in St. Louis, and we can't wait to crown the first ever winner in St. Louis here in June. I think it's going to be a very special event. And from a fan standpoint, we have so many fans here, not only in the Midwest region, but in St. Louis in particular. You know, that was a big reason for the decision for why we came to St. Louis and why we feel like this is an important and strategic move to the future of our sport. You look at the number of different sports teams you have here, from the Cardinals to the Blues, to the St. Louis SC Club that's coming in 2022. I think a lot of great storylines. The one sport you guys were missing was NASCAR. And we couldn't be more thrilled to be here. You guys have really made us proud. Everything you've done at the track throughout the past several years, and we know you'll make us proud as a Cup Series track in 2022. So thank you all again. Appreciate you having me here today, and looking forward to seeing you in June.
I'd like to welcome to the podium now the founding chair of Greater St. Louis, Inc., executive chairman of Holdings, and a great friend, Andrew Taylor.
Well, how does it feel to be living in the best sports town in America right now? The Cardinals have been mentioned. I see Chris out here with the Blues. Of course, we have St. Louis City SC starting in 2023. Thank you very much. We also hosted the 2020 Olympic trials for gymnastics. We just finished the Ascension PGA Championship, which is a massive success. And we had the 2018 PGA tournament out at Belle Reve a couple years ago, which was a massive success. We are one hell of a sports town. And I mentioned, as I walked up here, I saw Michelle Tucker, who's CEO of United Way. St. Louis is also known as probably the most charitable and giving town in the entire country. So thank you, Michelle. And next June, we'll have NASCAR. Isn't that just amazing? So to the NASCAR organization and the France family, thank you so much for your belief in St. Louis, and we plan to over exceed your expectations. So well done. And Curtis, congratulations to you and the Stewart family. You have worked really, really hard for years, and I know a little bit about what it takes to get a sports franchise up and running. Well done and congratulations. Now, St. Clair Board Chairman Mark Kern is not here today, I'm told, but he has been instrumental in his work on this from the east side. And he not only does great things on the east side, but he also thinks regionally. And that's really, really important for Greater St. Louis, where we're trying to build jobs and economic growth for the entire region. So thank you very much, Mark. With me today are a couple of people on the stage. Ken Sella, who is Edward Jones, and Suzanne Sitherwood of Spire. They have been absolutely indispensable to helping form Greater St. Louis, and they are leading civic heroes. So thank you guys very much for being here. I'd also like to acknowledge the leadership of Mark Lombardi, Chair of the Board of Directors of the St. Louis Sports Commission. Earlier this year, this team joined me and leaders throughout the metro area to come together to make our case to NASCAR and the France family. So thank you. I don't know where Mark is, but thank you for that hard work. And to all of our members of Greater St. Louis, Inc., thank you for your support, your contributions, your volunteerism. And today, NASCAR and St. Louis are creating a winning combination that is perfectly STL made. Thank you all very much.
And now, our track naming sponsor, founder and chairman of Worldwide Technology, Dave Stewart.
I don't know what that means to you. This means a lot to me. It's cup time. I was at a Blues game, which I'm one of the partners. We were having an interesting and fun time at this playoff game and so forth as well, and I had some interesting guests with me. They were from NASCAR, and he was wearing this hat. He took it off his head and gave it to me for the investment that we have been making in NASCAR, but also in the Richard Petty team, Bubba Wallace. And he signed it and the whole bit, and I almost fainted, and the thing about it is that it was very special for me because it connected me back to my hometown of milking cows and slopping hogs. And racing was a part of the small community that I grew up in. And as I reflect back on that, obviously it's connected to my son as well. His favorite race car driver was number five, right? Speed Racer. That's about as close we could get connected to this. But after getting tied with Curtis Francois and the rest of the team and the whole bit, he caught the bug as well. He's gone to racing school. He's got licenses and all kinds of stuff that I wouldn't dream of participating in. But let me thank Larry Albus. And the only reason I'm saying Larry Albus's name because Larry Albus introduced me to racing for the first time again in my life and connected the old to the new when he came to a birthday party of mine and he presented me with a gift of being the Grand Marshal of the race for that year. And that was 5 years ago. And one of the most significant things that happened to me at that race was the fact that I had the opportunity to see firsthand who they were putting first. They were putting God first, and they prayed at the beginning of the race. And that so impressed me. I said, I have to be a part of this. And we've got to do something to be tied to it in a way, in a meaningful way. And as you can tell, it's the Worldwide Technology Raceway that's bringing us in partnership with the Francois family. So I'm grateful for that. Let me not forget somebody very, very important that was an integral part of this that hasn't been mentioned, that absolutely have to mention before I sit down today. And that's Amy, Francois, stand up please, so we can see you. Now this doesn't happen, Curtis. You know this. You're gonna get a jail free card on me, right? It doesn't happen without a supportive wife. Over a 12-year period of time doing this and sacrificing the commitment made to the sport, and then the amount of times away and collaborating and partnering with NASCAR, and the countless hours that you've spent away from home doing that. Thank you for your sacrifice. Thank you for your commitment to St. Louis and that very special wife. You know, and the other thing too, as I began to reflect back, not only the King, Ricky Petty, Parnelli Jones in my day, and people like that, but also there's someone very, very special that we've been spending an awful lot of time with, and Wendell Scott family. Wendell Scott was the first black driver in NASCAR. He retired in 1973. He was a phenomenal innovator. Had a tremendous amount of grit, determination to make it through a very difficult sport at the time, and they celebrated him back in Daytona just this past month, and a trophy that he did not receive in 1963, he received at Daytona. His family received that trophy, and so he said, "We're standing on the shoulders of men like that, determined, just overcome many obstacles for us to have the opportunities that we have today." I'm so thankful for him and his family and the legacy that they're leaving for us and for us to stand on, the opportunity they've provided for us now to represent a new age of NASCAR. A broader and deeper NASCAR, and an audience that diversity and inclusion that this sport has never seen before. I'm very thankful that the France family sees the opportunity and so forth. We've been spending an awful lot of time collaborating and working in diversity and inclusion, and they've seen some of the things that we're able to do at the racetrack, and I think that's made a huge difference in the kind of decision was made on this as well. The future of NASCAR has an inclusion version on this, and we have had many events at the raceway around STEM, science, technology, engineering, and math, that included not only about around the driver, how significant that it is for young people to see that firsthand. For them to have the opportunity to be able to see themselves in the driver's seat or in support of the sport in a way that they had never seen before. Jackie Joyner-Kersee's been an integral part of that. And Valerie Patton and Dr. McCoy and many others have just stepped up in meaningful ways that allows us to be able to get the ITSMF and BDPA and BEAs and NPowers and Boys and Girls Clubs of and United Way engaged in a way that haven't been engaged before. So the next generation is going to be prepared